Everything here is traditional. The design is local and cultural. The buildings are thatched and built out of local materials. This is George Costen Vocational Training College in Mpongwe. It is a skills center which will be serving young people of Mpongwe and other surrounding areas. The doors of the ablution blocks are well decorated with bamboos. The walls are made out of mukwa and kayuba trees. All this is being done to create employment for the local people. This vocational college is one of the projects under the foundation Give the Children of Mpongwe a Future. The project will offer young people a number of options. The foundation is the personal initiative of Ton Costen Korenkromp, a lecturer at Zuid University in the Netherlands.
So we started income-generating projects, and it was our guest house. That was our first income-generating project. It's the only guest house who's really well in the district, I think, and people like the place. We have also women groups. We are supported by this organic farming courses. And but in the meantime, my late husband, he saw a lot of pupils here who don't go to school, hanging around after grade 12, drop out from grade 7, and he said, what you have to do here is to build a vocational training school, because Pongwe needs this school, because there's a lot of construction work, there's a lot of maintenance to do, but also for priority has the students that they don't have to go to Lusaka or to Kitwe to follow further education.
Design of this structure has provided for the anticipated weather conditions. One of the principles of this vocational training center is that of energy conservation. Water will also be harvested and conserved for irrigation during dry season.
We don't want to use a lot of water, so what we do, we harvest it. So we have the grey water and the brown water from the sanitary block. The grey water is from the showers and the brown is from the toilets. The brown one goes to a septic tank, of which the overflow goes to a gutter, which leads it to a filter gutter. In a trajectory of 60 meters, we filter the water and we store it in a basin. That basin is 140,000 liters, which we think is enough to use it as irrigation during the dry seasons.
Students will be inculcated with preventive measures so that no one tampers with this thatched structure.
The students that are going to come will be sensitized and be told they need to guard against any form of vandalism, because it will be their property. Not them who are going to come, some other people. Their children, their children, their children will come here. So we will sensitize them, even the community.
For the people of Mpongwe, the construction is heaven sent.
We will try to attract other people who are elsewhere to come and help develop Mpongwe. Look at that old lady whose interest developed when she visited Mpongwe, simply maybe as a visitor or as a tourist. And then she thought she had a role to play to see the orphans and other people who were desperate in need of education. This organization is helping our district by funding those children who are unable to meet the school needs.
Phase 1 of the construction is expected to be completed in 2014, with the first bunch of students being enrolled. The Phase 1 will consist of 4 classrooms, facility rooms, library, administration block, and dormitories. The expansion works will continue in Phase 2 until 2018, which is the ultimate deadline for the completion of all the works. Queen Chungumalama, TV1 News in Mpongwe.